My dad actually had the honour, if you can call it that, of actually leading the first of our soldiers into action on a Kokoda track. Yeah, look, my dad was a soldier, but he never really regarded himself as a soldier. He was someone who served his country when the call went out, and as it did back in 1939. And he served with the 2nd 14th Battalion in North Africa and Syria. He was promoted from sergeant to lieutenant, brought back to Australia and sent up to New Guinea, where he was one of the young officers with the 39th Battalion. 39th Battalion, of course, were just kids, average age around 18, and they were sent off to man an airstrip and ran into the Japanese invasion force. And that's when the battle for the Kokoda track began. And then he finished his active service on the northern coast of New Guinea early the next year, and then he was flown back to Australia with just about every disease they had going up there. And after some rehabilitation over in South Australia, he went to Victoria Barracks and stayed there for the rest of the war. Interestingly, when I was born, even though he was a commissioned officer in the army, on my birth certificate it gives his occupation as bread carter. So that's what I mean about him not regarding himself as primarily a soldier. Being a soldier was something you did when you had to do it, not something that it wasn't a career for him. So I grew up on a soldier settlement at Robinvale, and a lot of things about growing up in a soldier settlement quite different to other places, because the whole spirit of mateship was there amongst all of the settlers. There was a lot of good that they brought back with them, which in terms of supporting each other and backing each other, but there was a dark side to it as well. And growing up with it was actually hard to see that, you know, things that seemed to be normal to us then, looking back, not quite so normal. And my dad suffered from what today they'd call PTSD, and fairly badly at that. Most of the time, you know, you couldn't get a better dad, but then the mood swings could come very, very quickly. And so while I love my dad intensely, there was also a level of fear in it, that because of the mood swings, because you never knew when something might set him off. And it could be something really small, something really simple, like, you know, sticking my billy can in the trailer of stuff when we were going home from camping, for example. And that brought out about a 5-second burst of real anger from Dad. And it's, I think about it now, irrational, but, you know, he was dealing with his issues, and probably better than most of us would, because they had a lot of resilience back then. But the soldier settlement experience taught me a lot about working for your community, about backing each other up, about supporting each other, and the spirit of mateship, which is not the same as friendship. People think it's about friendship. It's not about friendship, it's about mateship. And they did things like one of the settlers who couldn't work his property for a couple of years because of illness, which meant he would have lost his property to the department. And about 30 guys would turn up once a month and do a month's work in a day. And that went on for about a year and a half to 2 years. You know, I never got the impression they actually really liked the guy. But, you know, he was one of theirs. They were mates because of what they'd been through and what they shared together. And that's the important thing. Someone's house burnt down. No one had insurance, and no one actually liked the people who lived in the house, as far as I'm concerned, but that might have just been me. But the whole district came together and built them a new house because no one had insurance in those days. That's something you'd go a long way to find today. But that to me is the Aussie spirit, and the spirit of mateship that is the backbone of this country. And you get it today in all the volunteers everywhere who are working to serve their community. Same thing, not getting shot at quite as often, which is a good thing. One of the things that bothers me is the way politicians in particular get on board this whole thing of glorifying the dead and glorifying the wars. And I think that they're wrong in both counts. I think that if you're going to glorify anything, if you're going to recognise anything, it's the service and those who served. Not those who are unlucky enough to die in the process, but those who actually put their life on the line to serve the country. And sometimes they don't get the support that they deserve to get when they get back home again. Yeah, look, I believe it's important to honour the warrior, not the war. It's those who serve their country, regardless of what the war is. It's up to the politicians to make the decisions about whether we go to war. No soldiers should ever be involved in that decision making. But when their country calls, those who answer the call deserve to be honoured for that.